is David Bryan. In a moment, we'll bring you another case from the files of Mr. District Attorney. And now, here is our star, David Bryan, as Paul Garrett, Mr. District Attorney. Crime, a district attorney is dealing basically with human reactions and characteristics. Thus, in the solving of crime, he learns to look for such things as personal vanity for the giveaway. Just about twilight one afternoon, a small pickup truck turns from a suburban shopping district into a street of apartment houses.
Me, riding in a truck and wearing coveralls. You asked me to go this to the bird.
Well, what's wrong with a truck? You don't even have to drive. All you got to do is pull the trigger.
It ain't good for my self-respect.
You took on even more high-tone manner since you've been away, huh?
Howdy the dude, it fits. Okay, but I don't like anybody telling me how to do my work. Who does Dave William think he is?
Just the guy who's paying us, that's all.
What's Dave got against this guy Simmons?
All I know is what the boys are saying. Simmons is in real estate. He handled a deal when the city bought a piece of land out here in Brandon Heights to make an old playground.
Dave cut himself in, huh?
Yeah. Being city council up in this ward, he got the council okay to purchase. Only he added $100,000 onto the price. Then he held down on Simmons. Dave is also in politics if the story gets out, so he wants the hush-hush put on Simmons.
We ought to be right along. Get some from work right on the button. This is him now, Artie.
In a big convertible?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's class. That's for me.
Now let him go by and then pull up alongside.
Get as close as you can, Joe.
Pull ahead some more. Come on.
Okay. What do you think I got here? A flying saucer?
That's good. Hold it steady.
He's gonna crack that tree.
I hate to see a car like that smashed up.
See anyone around?
No.
You?
No.
It's a cinch now, Artie. We leave the trucks at the filling station, get out of these coveralls in the washroom, grab a cab to the highway, and wait till Dave shows up.
Nice work, Artie. Nice work.
Sorry I had to call you this late in the day. All the way out here in the suburbs, too.
What they pay me for, Harrington?
Officer incidental.
Funny that that car's a mess.
Yeah. I'm glad I wasn't in it.
Simmons, did you say?
That's right, Fred Simmons. Real estate man, bachelor, early 30s.
Any motive apparent for this murder?
No, not yet, Chief. Could be a gang job, though. Some hoods letting go from a passing vehicle. Maybe a truck.
Well, what do you mean, maybe a truck?
Well, you see that delicatessen sign just past the drugstore?
Yeah.
A guy named Al Wiley runs that delicatessen. He heard three shots. Heard the car crash the tree. Got to the door in time to see a vehicle make a left turn where the streetlight is. Thinks it was a quarter-ton pickup truck.
Contact radio division. Alert all prowl cars to be on the lookout for a quarter-ton pickup in this area. And probably abandoned by now.
Will do, Chief. You be at the office?
Later on, after I talk with the medical examiner, we'll want a complete fill-in on Simmons, too. Character, business associates, social background, everything.
Mm-hmm.
If it's a gang killing, it could be a tough one to crack. Let's get on it, Hargan.
District Attorney's office.
Good morning, Bright Eyes. This is Don Juan.
I'm thrilled. What do you want, Harrington?
The chief in yet?
No.
I don't wonder. He worked most of last night.
Any message? Oh, wait a minute. Here he is. Harrington, Mr. Garrett.
Thanks. Yes, Harrington?
Hi, Chief. I'm at a filling station. Brandon Heights, Maple and Dorchester Streets. City pickup truck was left here overnight. When the truck drove in, two guys in coveralls got out and went into the washroom. He didn't notice when they came out.
Anything else?
Yep. A 45 caliber cartridge case was on the running board. That's what made this guy report it in.
It's beginning to add up now, Harrington. Medical examiner said Simmons was killed with 45 caliber bullets. Hold that truck till I get out there.
Okay, Chief.
You got my note about Simmons, Miss Miller?
Yes, I'm just typing it up.
I wasn't able to get much of a fill-in on him last night. Got sidetracked, looking for witnesses, talking with stoolies. All of them deaf and dumb.
Do I try the real estate board, Mr. Garrett?
That's a good idea. Also call the chief of the city maintenance crew and truck dispatcher, too. Find out why one of their pickups should be left overnight at a Branding Heights filling station. Who was driving it and all the details.
Yes, sir.
Oh, one thing more. Check the modus operandi of this murder with Lieutenant O'Brien, Detective Division. Some specialist in motorized killing seems to be in town. And I guess that's all.
You're getting those dark circles under your eyes again, Mr. Garrett.
Huh?
You better get a good night's sleep tonight. After all, you can't work around the clock.
The trouble is we're dealing with crime, Miss Miller. And crime does work around the clock. I'll be back in a couple of hours.
Yes, sir.
Got out here quick, Chief.
That's the truck over there, eh?
Yeah. I'll go get the knife man. He wanted some food. We didn't think he'd get out here so soon.
You got his story, didn't you, Harrington?
Yeah.
I'll let him have his breakfast. I'll talk to him when he gets back. In the washroom unlocked?
No. I got the key. I didn't look in there yet, Chief. Waited for you. The only place they could have hid the gun is in that towel disposal unit there. There we are, Chief. Just a bunch of used paper towels.
Dump them out on the floor. They're towels, huh? Look again, Harrington.
Hey. Coverall. Two sets of them.
May have had these on over their regular clothes. Stuffed the coveralls in that unit, walked down the street to a waiting automobile, or maybe they took a taxi.
I'll check the cab companies.
Have the lab boys take along these coveralls. Come on, let's go talk to your night man.
Lieutenant O'Brien called, Mr. Garrett.
And?
About your MO request. He said there were half a dozen trigger men in town who could have done that job.
You got the list, Miss Miller?
Yes, right here.
Mickey Stone, Gypsy Delpot, Pope Madroni, Joe Caesar, Artie the Dude.
Lieutenant wanted to know if you wanted any of them brought in for questioning.
Absolutely. Unless they've got ironclad alibis.
I'll call him back.
You got anything on Simmons?
The secretary of the real estate board said Simmons was pretty much a lone wolf. None of the real estate people knew him well. He said he cultivated politicians, put over a couple of unethical deals. The board reprimanded him.
Politicians, huh? Let's see now. Councilman Dave Lillian was in on that playground deal. He recommended the purchase to the city council.
He's the one who ordered the inspection of city-owned trucks to be held yesterday.
Now, who told you that?
The chief of the maintenance crew. He thinks the pickup was driven away during the afternoon.
Well, I'll buy that. Have we anything on Dave Lillian in our files?
I'll see him, Mr. Garrett. Langdon, Libby. Lillian, yes.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. Dave Lillian started that truck corps when he cut his rates on long-distance hauling. Question and murder of truck driver from rival company. Oh, bodyguard. I'll be...
You found something?
It could be. Now, while I'm out, Miss Miller, call the man who sold that playground land to the city. As I recall, his name is Sloan. Ask him to come here to the office. We're going to dig into that deal.
Yes, sir.
Oh, right now, call Harrington, police lab. Tell him I'll pick him up in 5 minutes.
Shall I tell him where you're going?
Yeah, to Dave Lillian's office. That bodyguard of Lillian's was Artie the Dude Campello.
Come in.
Jarrett, district attorney, Mr. Lillian. See, we met at the athletic club's banquet last year.
Oh, yeah. How are you, Jarrett?
My assistant, Mr. Harrington.
Glad to know you.
How do? Sit down, boys. What can I do for you?
Well, you know Fred Simmons was murdered last night, I suppose.
Yeah. Too bad. Nice guy, Fred. Don't know who's going to get him.
You know him well?
Oh, just in a business way. He got me interested in that land for the playground out in my ward. Kids need a playground bad.
The city paid plenty, I understand.
Only good piece of property around. Owner knew it, held out for his price, city paid it. People wanted that playground.
$250,000.
Wow.
Did Sloan get all that?
What do you mean, did he get all of it? Certainly he did. It's on the city books. Go take a look. Did Sloan get all of it?
Mr. Lillian, why did you order the inspection of the city trucks to be held ahead of schedule?
Because I'll be out of town in 2 weeks for a month on business. Wanted to get the inspection over with before I leave.
Seems like quite a coincidence those trucks should be ordered out the day Timmons was murdered.
Look, Garrett, what are you trying to say?
Just that.
If you're making any cracks, you better pull in your neck back. I don't know nothing about it. I was in the mayor's office when it happened, so just lay off, see? I got plenty of political influence. I could have your job, just like that.
Why, you redneck...
I'm not accusing anybody, Mr. Lillian. Not yet. But stick around, brother. It may not be too long. This is David Bryan. Before we continue with Mr. District Attorney in the case of the land swindle murder, here is an important message from our sponsor.
Back to David Bryan, starring as Paul Garrett, Mr. District Attorney.
Investigations show that the pickup truck murder of Fred Timmons, real estate agent, might be linked to a recent sale of land to the city for a suburban playground. A deal which Timmons had handled together with City Councilman Dave Lillian. When I asked Dave Lillian why he had ordered the city-owned trucks left out in the parking area for inspection 2 weeks ahead of the regular schedule, he blew his top and threatened to have my job. Now, a couple of days later...
District Attorney's office.
Paul Garrett, Miss Miller.
Yes, Mr. Garrett.
I'm over at the police lab. Anything come in?
2 reports. Folsom Detective Division.
What are they?
Two of those trigger men have sound alibis, Stone and the drone. Joe Delcott's about to be in Chicago. Lieutenant O'Brien's taking on him through the Chicago police.
What about Artie Campello?
Well, they're looking for him. Also for Joe Caesar.
Tell him to put on more men. Comb the city. I want those hoods brought in.
Yes, sir. The second report, a stakeout's been assigned to cover Dave Lillian. That's all at present.
Okay. You gotten in touch with Sloan yet, Miss Miller?
No, his secretary won't give me any information. Just says Sloan and his wife are out of town on vacation. She doesn't know where they went or when they'll be back.
All right. Then do this. Get a list of Sloan's relatives with addresses. Also his wife's relatives. People on vacation send back postcards. We'll locate Sloan that way.
I'll check on that right away, Mr. Garrett.
Good. Call me back if anything breaks.
Yes, sir.
Got anything, Harrington?
Yeah, finally, Chief. Sergeant sent his apologies. Got 3 men out with the flu. A bunch of reports to the commissioner.
Yes, I know. Now, those photo blow-ups?
Uh-huh. 5 of this one, a rough cloth suit inside one set of his coveralls. Rubbed off. Could be from one of those heavy scotch tweeds.
Yeah, those tweeds cost money.
Plenty. You want me to check the clothing stores that might sell these tweeds?
It wouldn't do any harm, Harrington. At least get a list of them. Won't be many that sell that expensive stuff.
And I'll get a list of the stores. Sergeant's downstairs. Shall I answer that?
Yes, might be for me.
Police laboratory.
Mr. Garrett, still there?
He sure is. Just a second. It's Miss Miller, Chief.
Thanks. Yes, Miss Miller?
I just had a call from the Northside Cab Company, Mr. Garrett. One of their drivers picked up 2 men out in Brandon Heights about 5:30 the night of the murder. Eddie Marco drives a night shift. 4 in the afternoon until midnight.
I can now go right out there. Call him back.
Tell them to have Marco at the company's office. I'll also ask them to pull that cab off the street. Put a standby on it for the lab boys in case this one bounces right.
Yes, Mr. Garrett.
Thanks, Miss Miller. Bye now.
Bye.
That's the chief, huh?
Well, we don't know yet. What's the name of that police artist? The one that does those crayon drawings.
Oh, Sigaletti. Mike Sigaletti.
Well, call him. Tell him we want him to go along out to the Brandon Heights. Stop in 5 minutes. Bring his kit.
Okay.
This may be the break we need, Harrington. You can be setting up, Mike, while we establish the route on this map.
Okay, Mr. Garrett.
Now, Marco, show me where you picked up those two men.
Just let me find where I am on the map.
Here's Maple and Dorchester, right here.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Right about here is my stand, see? Just past the Brandon Theater. The two guys got in at the stand.
Well, where'd you drop them off?
Over at the corner of Edgemont and Carlton.
Trace the route for us on the map, the way you went from your stand.
I drove up here to 9th Avenue, went straight out Riverside, and there's Edgemont and Carlton.
Marco, did you notice him throw anything out of the cab? You know, anything like a gun, for example?
No. Like I said, I wasn't paying much attention,
What'd they look like? Their builds?
Well, one of the guys was about medium height, built pretty solid. The other one was small and skinny, about my build. I noticed him because he was a sharp dresser. Oh, boy.
Go on.
Well, he was wearing a suit like one of them English suits you see in the movies.
Tweed?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, I guess that's what it was. I don't know much about tweed.
You get a look at his face.
It's pretty good. He's the one who gave directions.
Hold it, Marco. You ready, Mike?
Yes.
Now, he's going to make a drawing of your description, Marco, so don't talk too fast.
I'll keep up with him, Mr. Garrett.
Okay. He had kind of a what, Marco?
Kind of narrow face-like. Long jaw. It kind of faded back a little, though, you know.
What about the eyes? Protrude or deep set?
Deep set. Close together, too. I noticed that okay.
Nose? Long? Short? Flat?
Pretty long, I'd say.
Like this?
Yeah.
Eyebrows? Arched or flat?
Gee, I don't remember about them.
Like this?
No, that don't ring no bell.
Well, like this then?
Yeah, more like that.
Remember about the ears?
They stuck out from his head. He had a hat on, too, kind of an old squash felt hat. Didn't go with his suit at all.
Okay. That look anything like a Marco?
Yeah. Hey, I'll say it looks like him. It is him.
You swear to that?
I'll say I would, Mr. Gert. Hey, don't I wish I could draw like that? I wouldn't. That's Audie the dude, Chief.
The Audie, your twin brother. How about the other guy, Marco? Can you describe his face?
Well, I try. Won't be so good, though. I didn't know him so much.
Now, do your best. Be right back after I find the phone and call my office. Harrington.
Okay, Chief. Phone right down this corridor.
We'll have Mike make copies of those drawings. Check them in with R&I. They must have a mugshot of Artie and Joe Caesar. The other one is Joe.
I bet on it. They've worked together before.
Now we've got to find the store where Artie bought that suit. Ransack this town. Also the town where he's been. O'Brien will know. Show the salesman the drawings and the mugshots.
Got it, Chief. What else?
Extend the search for the murder weapon along the rest of the route. Get stakeouts in that area around Edgemont and Carlton.
All over with the shouting, that Chief?
No, it isn't. The jury's want proof, remember? And so far, we haven't got proof.
Good morning, Mr. Garrett.
Good morning, Miss Miller. Or good afternoon.
It's only 11 o'clock.
I overslept. First time that's happened in months.
You needed it.
Good for the dark circle, eh?
I'm nearly gone.
Then I'll try oversleeping again sometime.
Do that tomorrow morning.
You'll spoil me, Miss Miller. Any calls?
Harrington called in some time ago.
Good.
He found out that Sloan's wife has a sister living out at the Heights. So he's going to try to find out from her where Sloan is.
Well, we've got to locate that guy, and soon. Maybe he's the one that ordered the murder. Maybe Timmons held out on him.
Sloan?
I said maybe, Miss Miller. At least I don't know that he didn't.
Morning, Chief.
Good morning, Harrington.
Will you look at that grin on him, Mr. Garrett?
Yeah. Let's have it.
Well, Sloan's in Miami, Florida. Got his address right here.
Got it from his sister-in-law.
Oh, easy. You know how it is with me and women, Chief. I charm them.
Aren't you wonderful?
All kidding aside, you had the right hunch about that postcard business. And the lady didn't know anything at all was wrong. I told her I was anxious to get in touch with Sloan on the business matter. She opened right up. Got the card from her sister yesterday afternoon.
You earned yourself a trip, Harrington.
What do you mean, Chief?
Trip to Florida. Reserve a seat for Harrington on a plane south, Miss Miller.
Yes, sir.
He's going to Miami to bring Sloan back.
Sit down, will you, Artie? You make me nervous all the time walking around. So what do I do? Sit down and twirl my thumb some more? Look, Joe, either I get out of this apartment tonight or I go nuts. Be dark in another half hour. I'm going out and catch a movie. See what's in the papers.
Hey, you're taking a chance.
Okay, I'm taking a chance. Hey, stay up here. I'm taking a chance going off my rocker. You come out with me, Joe?
I don't know. I think it over.
I wish I'd stayed in Cleveland. Doesn't work coming back here for that job. Hold it, Artie.
Put that gun out of sight. Maybe the cops.
Cops, they'll shoot it out. They ain't taking me.
Who is it? Me, Davy Lillia. Open up, will you?
Let him in, Artie. It's about time you showed up, Lillian.
Get your things together, boys. You gotta get out of here in a hurry.
What's wrong?
What's right, you mean?
Ain't you read the papers? Told us to stay in his hideout, didn't you?
Well, what's in the papers?
The DA's busting this case wide open. Had Sloan brought from Miami. The guy spilled over plenty. Said he sold that land for only $150,000 and how I gave him $5,000 extra to swear the city paid him $250,000. Get your things together. My car's up the block. Come dark, we're shaking this town. For keep.
That's the apartment house, Hagen. Pull in here.
Is that the one Lillian went in?
Brownstone front. Yes, according to the stakeout message, it is. Hope we're not too late.
We going in after them, Chief?
If necessary. We'll wait out here for a few minutes, though. They might come out. Let's get out of this car.
Okay.
Better get close to the building.
Maybe they've already skipped it.
I think they'd wait till dark. It's getting dark now.
Wait a minute, hold it. There's somebody coming out. Three guys. It's them, Chief.
Come on.
All right. Oh, they've spotted us.
Stop him, Sergeant.
There goes Artie back into the building. In the lobby, Chief. Trying to unlock the inner door. May have a gun.
Knock it off, Artie.
You ain't taking me, Copper. You want to shoot it out, okay?
Watch him, Chief.
Don't reach for that gun, Artie. I don't want to have to kill you.
Nice shooting, Chief. I thought he had you.
The boy stopped those other two?
I'll have a look. Yep, they got him. Dave Lillina and Joe Caesar.
Hey, get a doctor, will you? This arm hurts bad.
You'll get your doctor, Artie. Speaking of guns, that .45 on the floor interests me. Bring it along, Harrington. We'll have ballistic test fire. It might be the murder weapon. Put the handcuffs on him, Harrington.
Right.
In a storm.
All right. We're going right down to headquarters. There'll be a doctor there. But believe me, Artie, you've got more to worry about than that arm. Plenty more. Let's go. This is David Bryan again. I hope you've enjoyed this case from the file of Mr. District Attorney. I'll be back in just a moment after this message from our sponsor.
star of Mr. District Attorney, David Bryan, with a word about the program you have just heard.
You may recall the case. The gun we took from Artie the Dude turned out to be the murder weapon. That and the testimony of the taxi driver Marco and the clothing store clerk who sold Artie the tweed suit did the job. Artie and Joe Caesar were convicted of murder in the first degree. Dave Lillian, convicted of hiring the killers, got a life sentence. For aiding and abetting in an attempt to defraud, Sloan was sentenced to 5 years in state prison. Now, this is David Bryan inviting you to join us when we present our next case based on the facts of crime from the file of Mr. District Attorney.
Mr. District Attorney was originated by Philip H. Lawrence.